Radcliffe McConey for the last time on Radio 2. We're together, anyway.
Yeah.
And certainly with Nod. And welcome, Manic Street Preachers. How are you?
Yo, hola. How you doing?
Very good. Very good. Are you in fine voice? You keep threatening to have a shout-off with Sir Nod.
I think I'd lose in a shout-off with Sir Nod tonight because I got a tickly throat, so I would lose. I get trampled by him, I think.
Is your throat all right? Because, I mean, you couldn't come last time, could you? Because
I know.
And you had to change the Blackwood thing. You get slightly older, is your throat becoming a more susceptible to all kinds of things?
I'm a fragile old thing these days.
You don't understand vocalists. So
come on, sing us Union Nod.
I was talking to James earlier about it, that you don't understand vocalists. We're very tender people. Yeah. We have to look after
tender
our
petals.
Cords.
And,
I think delicate as a lace-winged butterfly.
Absolutely.
Every time people used to see you sing Nod, the first word that sprung to mind was tender.
Delicate.
And delicate.
Yes. It was a bit like Nick Drake, your image, wasn't it? The sensitive, introspective singer-songwriter.
Yeah, absolutely. That was the other side of me, which you've never seen.
Oh. No, in all these years.
Oh, leave him alone.
Oh, right. So what have you been up to? What's been happening in the Manics camp?
Well, you've been making a fantastic record, haven't you?
No, it's been it's been a fantastic 6 months. We're kind of winding down before the summer season starts, you know?
Right.
I've signed with Faber and Faber. That's the big news, really.
Yeah.
Have you?
Is it for fiction or non-fictional poetry or what?
I don't know yet.
Oh, you're not deciding
yet? I've just lied to him. I'm doing so.
Really?
it's been busy. It's been brilliant. It's been, love making the album. We love playing the album. We're going to finish off in style in summer.
Yeah? Right, okay.
It's been a really, all the cliches are true, mighty resurgent record and all that. And has it done all the things you wanted it to do?
I think it did, yeah. I mean, it was a follow-up to Send Away the Tigers. Mm. And it was received as well as Send Away the Tigers and better, I think, and it didn't, and they sold the same. And I don't know, at the end of the day, it felt like a triumph for a band on its 10th album. That's just the bottom line, and that's the way we wanted it to be.
Absolutely, yeah.
Right, okay. You're travelling very light today. I mean, last time you were here, there was the five of you with the full rig in it, and it's like acoustic guitar, acoustic
it's
bass.
It's a perfect analogy for how the economy is, isn't it?
Last time,
it was hundreds of us. Now it's just three carrying our own guitars.
Well, you're not, are you, in fairness? There is someone, certainly not quite.
Anyway, you're one tech with us. Give us a break.
You're all right.
I'm 42 years old.
Yeah. And a driver and a chef and a hairdresser.
You see my hair? You think I'm a hairdresser?
What are you going to do for us? Thank you very much for coming.
Really appreciate you doing this. Yeah.
What are you going to do
Don't worry,
for
we turn up for anyone who plays us.
So it's not war, just the end of love.
Okay, great.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Just
Yo.
Oh, fantastic stuff. Manic Street Preachers, It's Not War, Just the End of Love from Postcards from a Young Man. They're terrific current record.
Player for Joy Nottingham, he says, can you wish my sister Stella well as she tries to get as many Manic's lyrics onto her T-shirt and banner for this Saturday's march in London? And also Gareth Oram wants to say, can you thank James for wearing a Cardiff rugby top on the Jules Holland show?
God, that was a long time ago. That was like 1997.
Okay, a couple more songs from the Manics in the second hour of the programme. This is me and him, and also him, and also them, the Manic Street Preachers, with us. So, yeah, have you got loads of songs, James, for another record? Do you think that far ahead? Or, Nicky, have you got anything sorted? Any thoughts yet?
His initial idea was to beat Magnetic Field 69. So I have a 70 song album. I've tried to kibosh that.
70 songs. Yeah, yeah.
70 right. songs of failure and hatred.
It's a snappy title.
It's a winner.
Like Leonard Cohen.
Sony can't wait.
Right. So after the full-on thrutching rock Manics, it's downbeat Manics next time, is it, you think?
I think we'll find a third way somewhere.
Right.
I think we squeezed so much melody and kind of Manics-esque joy into this album. It did feel brilliant doing it. I just don't know if we could do that again. Really? I think we're just going to have to be slightly more indulgent, really.
Right.
You know, in a different kind of way. You know, we are entering the third phase of the Manics, you know. Could go completely tits up.
How close did it come to there being no second wave, no second wave of the Manics, you know? I mean, because there was a pretty, you know, patch where you really more or less decided to call it a day, wasn't there?
Oh, and it was just the dangling man syndrome. We were just, you know, just a band without a song. You know, we'd lost Richie, we'd lost Philip, our manager. You know, it was pretty coming out of the Holy Bible. It was, you know, it was just a horrible feeling.
Was there a moment when it turned? Can you remember? Was there a song or a gig or a meeting or a pint or? Was there something?
Well, no, there's never a pint never with a pint. Us. It's kind of like I've asked Nick and Sean to the pub a couple of times in my life, and I've just given up. I think it's kind of when we, you know, kind of Nick sent me the kind of lyrics for Design for Life, and I was living in Shepherd's Bush at the time, and kind of it took me about 10 minutes to write the tune to it, and I kind of, you know, made the call.
Yeah,
I think we've done it. I think we've got it. And that was the moment where I thought we could carry on and be another version of ourselves.
Yeah,
you know, but I remember just before that, I think I'd just seen Oasis and Top the Pops, and kind of Noel was kind of like holding his Union Jack guitar above his head, and I remember just going for a 5-mile walk in London, just thinking, why wasn't it us? It was kind of like it was all crashing in upon us at that point.
With a Union Jack guitar,
it would have been a Welsh rag.
The Design for Life you mentioned there, of course, getting quoted a lot these days, particularly the opening lines. Without getting into kind of thorny issues, do you feel that again, you know, that you are a band whose time is right again, you know what I mean? That you have, you know, that certain, do you know what I'm saying?
Well, that woman was writing slogans on the banner for Saturday.
Yeah, exactly, that the times need the Manic Street Preachers.
Oh, I do, I think we reflect just a kind of certain thought process that is extremely back in vogue.
Yeah.
And we've never changed, but
no.
I do think that, you know, people are realising, you know, it doesn't need me to point out the sham of this government, the kind of illegitimacy of this fake kind of coalition that decides to rip up their manifestos and just say, well, we're a coalition, so we didn't need to have a manifesto because now we're joined together. So everything they stood for has just been chucked away.
Essentially, so you didn't change. So these are the things, things been read. It's like Gloria Swanson quote about the pitches got small or whatever it is, you know, being the Sunset Boulevard. Yeah.
And we've got the royal wedding to actually just get our dander up as well.
Okay. Okay. Album in itself you could do.
Indeed, there is.
You've not been asked because to play at the park.
Come on, you want to keep this show clean now, don't you? I could go really Tourette on this.
I know. Okay, yeah. So. Well, me and Chris the editor were reminiscing about you going really Tourette on our ill-fated breakfast show.
I'd
forgotten about it, but Chris the engineer reminded me.
What was the prize? It was a foot spa. Was
a
it?
Foot spa?
Yeah, it was.
In fact, that was a competition called We Love Us, which was based on a Manic song where members of bands were tested on knowledge of their own band. Yeah. Did you do it?
I think I got 3 out of 5.
Yeah, who won?
I can't remember.
I don't know.
I just remember saying that Sean had 4 foot spars already. Why would I want another one?
I do remember presenting a foot spar to Sporty Spice.
I don't know if Sean's got my. Are you still as gadget and gizmo crazed as you always were?
I am, but I've sort of, got 3 kids now, so I've got to think about them rather than myself.
Oh, you buy for them as well?
Yeah. They've all got mini foot spas now.
I remember you got a foot spa app.
Yeah, kid, use a particle foot accelerator.
Yeah. I remember once coming to Mono Valley when you were recording...
This is my truth.
This is my truth. And I remember you said to me, what kind of car have you got? I said, why? You said, what kind of boot space has it got? I said, why are you asking me this show? He said, well, what if you got addiction? Do you decide to buy a lot of goods? You need a better boot space than that.
Have you got your own Hadron Collider yet, Sean?
No, I've just got Prius now, so. That's as close as I can get to
Hollywood
it.
Hollywood boy.
I've given in.
The Toyota Prius.
That's the word. Hence the box that I'm playing today. I'll be standing on it later.
Great. Okay. Let's. Actually, I'm just about to get some pious central eating. So let's. I'll fill you in on all the details, Sean, when we go to the pub. Okay, I'll tell James and he can pass it on. Right. Okay. What are you going to play for us now, guys?
You stole the sun from my heart.
Great. Thank you.
Drinking. What a Tuesday thing. Or is it to purify? I love you all the same. But there's no real twist with my fury. You don't have to believe me. I love you all the same.
Right.
I gotta stop smiling. It gives a wrong impression. I love you all the same.
Fantastic.
Excellent. Excellent. The Manic Street Preachers performing live and acoustic. We've got one more song to come from them before the end of the show.
So you're looking forward to your summer of gigs?
Yeah, yeah, we used to hate festivals. But kind of we've grown to love
them.
Love the sunshine. We're not the miserable Welsh weeds we used to be.
We always went down well at festivals. We always dreaded doing festivals because we were much more of a, we like to see the whites of their eyes. But every time we played a festival, we always stormed it. Every festival.
I remember
the
second coming of Slade, you know, Run Away and all that. When you played Reading, that was
amazing.
We
did Reading, yeah. It was a big one for us. That
was absolutely fantastic. Yeah. Underrated phase of Slade, that second.
It was, very much so. Underrated. Yeah.
Great. Okay, so should we have the last song?
Let's have your last song. What are you going to do for us?
Yeah, this is what this is over.
We were coming up in the car today, and me and Sean realised that this song was released 20 years ago. Motown Jank.
Oh, I've got an email from Lewis who said, could the Manics dedicate Motown Junk to my dog, Alfie? It's his first birthday, and whenever he hears Motown Junk, he runs around the table.
Well, we're dog lovers, so
Okay.
This one is definitely for Alfie.
Ready?
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Fantastic. The Manix, Motown Junk, and thank you very much for that, guys. We really appreciate you coming to doing this, by the way.
It's been a pleasure.
We do.
We really appreciate it.
And we appreciate all the support over the years. I have to say that, even though it's corny.
Corny's good. Corny's good. It's all right, yeah.